So the new Ryzen 5000 series CPUs have been released, and I have also made a review on the 5600X, which you can check out. But one interesting thing about the 5600X is that it is the only one of the new Zen 3 CPUs that comes with a Wraith cooler. So today we are going to check out if the stock cooler that comes in the box is good enough for this CPU or not, and if it will be a good idea to upgrade it to a better cooler. Hey guys, I am Siddharth, and let's get started. So while unboxing the retail package for Ryzen 5 5600X, we can see that it comes with a Wraith cooler that is identical to the one that came shipped with the Ryzen 3600. And I checked it quickly from all angles and couldn't notice a difference in size, weight or shape. For this video, we are going to compare it with an ASUS TUF Gaming LC240 All-in-One Liquid Cooler, and it is a 240mm liquid cooler like the name suggests, so this will give us a good comparison to the average liquid cooling performance. We are going to test this in a Fantex P400A with 4 fans installed, which we are going to run at full speed, and this is a case with really great airflow, so it should really help in showing what the Wraith cooler is capable of. We did remove the stock thermal paste that comes supplied on the cooler to keep this test consistent. We ran a 15-minute stress test with Prime 95 small FFT and also compared the temperature on idle, and we saw that at idle, the Wraith cooler ran 7 degrees higher than the TUF LC240, but on full load, we saw the stock cooler going up to 83 degrees, while with our liquid cooler, we remained at a pretty low 65 degrees Celsius with our room temperature being 24 degrees. So that's a quick answer to the question. It is going to go up to around 83 degrees, and that is actually not a bad temperature on Prime 95 small FFT workload, especially considering that it is one of the most stressful tests on the CPU, and on normal workloads like gaming and even while rendering on the CPU, it may not get as hot, but you also have to consider that we used it in a case with very good airflow with 4 fans running at full speed, and you may not have a situation that is as ideal. When you are gaming, you'll also have the heat from GPU, and if you are in India, you may see much higher temperatures in summer, so the temperatures on 5600X can go up to 90 degrees. Now people freak out when they see temperatures like these, and some people also have a problem with idle temperatures being in the 40s, but it is fine for your CPU unless you are constantly running it at over 90 degrees. CPUs are designed to handle this kind of heat, but it is better if you can keep it below 90 degrees. Now you don't have to buy a 240mm liquid cooler like this. You can also go with an entry level air cooler that will cost 2000 to 4000 rupees, and that should keep this CPU pretty cool, but it was interesting to see how low we can get with liquid cooling. So my recommendation would be to get a decent air cooler if you can, just like how it was with the 3600. You can run the 5600X with its stock cooler and you should mostly be fine with it. But if you are constantly pushing it, or you use it for rendering, or you don't have a case with great airflow, then getting an aftermarket cooler will definitely be worth it. And that was it for this video. I'll have links to some recommended coolers in the video description. Do give it a thumbs up if it was helpful. Let me know which cooler you are going to go with in the comment section below. Subscribe with bell. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.